Misty and Ron Cummings. Do you think it possible that Ron Cummings went over the top in his jail interviews? The first thing I thought of, as he repeatedly said that he would kill whoever he found to be the responsible for the murder or the death of Haley. But he kept doing it, kept saying it. And I decided that it was some sort of dodge, a deliberate red herring. You know, we had two women come on tonight. Pat Brown, who is a profiler, and she's one I like. And Bethany, again, she's a blonde, she's a psychologist, and she was also the author of Deal Breakers. Returning to Ron Cummings, the reporter asked him, what did he think that would happen now, and how long would Ron be, what do you think would be the sentence? And Ron didn't know. Pat Brown was very interesting, and it caused me to stop and reconsider when she said that it was Ron who was doing the lying, and that he was somehow involved in this. I remember that, okay, we know that he married Misty, and then he divorced Misty. And the proposed reason was that he wanted to be able to figure out or find out what she knew. But the thing that really caught my eye, here he had all this opportunity of being alone with Misty, and he never beat her up or forced her to come out with what she knew. And I don't know what you would do, but if my child was possibly missing for weeks, maybe months, and I was with somebody who tested so badly on the lie detector tests, I would not hesitate to put cattle prods on that person. There would be nothing I wouldn't do. And that's just the fact of the matter. I would not sit there and wait and hope that the police came up with something that they could use. I would take matters into my own hands. I wouldn't kill. I hope I wouldn't kill. Not if I was wanting to extract information. But I'd do something. And so why? Let's say that that's correct, that Ron didn't do anything, and he could have. What would be the reason? Why did Misty get a tattoo with her ex-husband's name? I think that it boils down to Misty is trying to soften up Ronald because she is afraid of him. I think Pat Brown, the profiler, criminal profiler, I think if she's not on the mark, she's not far from it. But Ron Cummings, did you notice, time and time again, he offered up that as proof of his innocence, that he hasn't killed anyone yet. And that he wouldn't have to tell anybody about it. the media would know all about, you know, that he killed somebody. And he did that over and over, and I think he did it one too many times, that he was offering this up as proof that he didn't know anything about Kaylee's death. I'll venture that he knows who took her, and it's mixed up with drugs. And as much as I wanted to believe him, he is a very good actor. We have to give him that. So, the tattoo with Ronald on there is to try to make Ron be nice to her. She's in search of a father figure and somebody that will keep her safe. And she may have chosen that. I liked Bethany Marshall's remark that Ron Cummings has no big picture thinking. He can't think of consequences of his acts. He's just a reactor. He's not much for thinking. So I think that's with this. I want to say a few words about women who marry celebrities. I suggest that the girlfriends all knew, these women who got cheated on, they all knew who they were marrying. They're cookie cutter men. They horrible, huge egos, and flattery will get you everywhere. And there's no mention of this woman who chased Edwards. I mean, she's a piece of work. I forget exactly the words that she used, but when she saw him in the hallways and cast her net for Edwards, she said something like, "Oh man, you are hot." Well, guess what? You know, when you're, you know, maybe he doesn't wear a toupee. Maybe he's just got air, you know, had some Boswell work on himself. And a blonde casts her net, you know, what are you going to do? And they're all doing it. There's, you know, Elin, Tiger's wife, she knew exactly who she was married. She might have been one of the party girls initially, you know, hostesses herself. I know nothing about her. But I do know all of these celebrity wives know exactly who they married. Then we have the wife of Jimmy Swaggart. And why did she go back to him? Because of the money. You know, with him going off doing his little thing and getting fired and everything, and, you know, living the gay lifestyle, she was suddenly without any income. So she was making, as they all do, they make decisions based on money. I don't care what they tell you or they tell reporters. Theirs is a monetary decision. So, I don't have any sympathy for any of them. You're much better off with just a guy that, you know, works 8 to 5 and brings home the bacon and is a good father and isn't out chasing around, you know, a fireman. They're 10 times better than these celebrity men. So anyway, there, I've got that off my chest. But these women, all of them, they knew exactly what they were getting into. You know, none of these guys need to be constantly fed compliments. Or they just shrivel up and die. Till next time.